Is the screen visible?
Yes, sir.
Fine. So far what we are seeing are the circuit reduction techniques. At the first we saw the sources. Okay, we saw what are the different types of sources. Then we saw the source transformation. When there are multiple sources or single sources, practical sources or ideal sources connected in the circuit, how best I can reduce the circuit and get the equivalent circuit, okay? We have seen. So that was with respect to the sources. Source transformation and source shifting was with respect to sources. Now, what if I have to reduce the complexity in the passive elements? Now, suppose I want to reduce the circuit complexity by reducing the complexity in passive elements. I am not touching the active elements now, because active element complexity reduction we already have seen, that source transformation and source shifting. But now what if the circuits are connected in a complex way with respect to the passive elements? Now I will take one simple circuit. I have this, sorry, let this be a simple circuit. Now, let this be the voltage V. We will not worry about how many number of sources are there and all those things. We don't need that now. We'll only think on the passive elements. Let this be R1, R2. Now, what is the effective value of resistance in the circuit? It is very simple. Series connection of two resistors.
Am I audible now?
No, sir.
Now am I audible?
No, sir.
Am I audible?
Yes, sir.
I think screen is visible now.
Yes,
Yes,
sir.
sir.
Now this is a very simple circuit. If I want to find the equivalent circuit of this, it is simple R1 plus R2. Right? Now I will add to the same circuit. I will take another color. R3 and R4. Now, what is the equivalent circuit? Equivalent resistance R3 in series with R4. That is, that combination is in parallel with R2, and this entire combination is in parallel with R1. Yes? Though I have increased only two resistors in the circuit, the number of steps increased by 3. Earlier it was only R1 plus R2. Now, if you have to calculate the effective resistance of the circuit, first you have to take R3 plus R4, then you have to take that combination in parallel to R2, then you have to add this combination in series with R1. So the amount of computations have increased. Now, further, I will increase the complexity. R5 R6 and R7. Now, two more steps have increased. First, I have to take sum of R5 plus R6 plus R7, take parallel that with R4, then take that with series with R3, then parallel with R2, then series with R1. Is it? Okay, this we are, we can do it fine, because at any point of time or at any point of computation, it is always either series combination or parallel combination. We haven't come across the combination which are beyond this. Okay, it is simple. Though the number of steps are increasing, but computations are very simple. Sum of R5, R6, R7, then parallel of R4 with that, sum of R3 with this combination, parallel to R2, sum of everything with R1. We know. Now, if circuit complexity is in such a way that I have this circuit, now with this connection, let me simplify this. Yeah, now let this be R1, R2, R3, R4, R5, R6, R7, and R8. Let this be V. Now, what type of combination has to be used? Can I say that R1 is in series with R2? These dark dots are the nodes, and if there is a node in between two elements, they are not in series. So between R1 and R2, there is a node. Between R1 and R4, there is a node. Between R3 and R2, there is a node. Between R3 and R5, there is a node. Between R5, R8, node. R5, R6, node. R7, R6, and R4, there is a node. So none of these eight registers are neither they are directly in series nor they are exactly in parallel. Do you agree?
Yes, sir.
I can't take R1 parallel R2 because they are not exactly in parallel like this R5 plus R6 plus R7 in parallel with R4. Now, if you take the effective value of this, this is R5 plus R6 plus R7. Now, R5 plus R6 plus R7 are connected exactly across the same nodes. Then they are parallel. But look here, R1 is connected, if I go on giving the nodes, let this be A, B, C, D, E, and F. Here also I will give the node names. Let this be same A, B, C, and D. Now observe, R5 plus R6 plus R7 is connected between B and C. R4 is also connected between B and C. Therefore, these two combinations are exactly in parallel. I can take effective resistance as a parallel combination of these two values. But if you observe R1 and R2, R1 is connected between A and B, R2 is connected between A and C, where there is no connection of R1 to node C here. R3 is connected between B and C, whereas alpha is connected between C and E. Alpha is not connected to B. So none of the resistors in this circuit are directly in parallel, nor they are directly in series. Then how to take the effective value of this combination? Now if you do source shifting here, the complexity will increase. So source shifting, source transformation equation is out of equation now. I am not worrying about the sources. Sources are kept as it is in the circuit now. Now I am interested to just simplify the complexity present in the passive elements. In case of R1, R2, R3, it can be resistors, capacitors, and inductors also. Okay, any passive elements, this can work. So with the direct series parallel combination calculation, I cannot find the equivalent resistance of this circuit. It is not possible at all. So we have to look into the methods which are beyond simple series and parallel combination calculations. And those methods are nothing but star delta transformations. Star delta transformation. So this circuit can be very conveniently solved to get its equivalent value circuit, equivalent resistance using star delta transformation. Using star delta transformation. We can very conveniently do that. Now first we have to look into what is star and what is delta connection. You have come across this in the basic electrical engineering in three phase networks. Yes? You remember? Or already it has evaded from your memory. Yes, star connection and delta connection. Okay. Now suppose I have three resistors. Let this be RA. With the terminal A dash. Let this be resistance RB with terminal B dash. And this be the resistance RC with terminal C and C dash. Okay. Now, how do I get the star connection? Yes. How do I get the star connection? Anybody?
Connect ABC to a single point.
Connect ABC to a single point, or A dash, B dash, C dash also to a single point. Because these are passive elements. Because these are passive elements, these are considered to be bilateral elements. So therefore, the one end of all the elements, if they are connected to a common point, then that connection will give a star connection. Okay. So how do we get star connection is one end of all elements are connected commonly. One end of all elements are connected commonly. That is, if I have this resistors A dash, B dash, C dash, having values Ra, Rb, and Rc, if I connect all these to a common point, okay, then this connection is known as star connection. This connection is known as star connection, and the point where all the ends of each element is connected is called as neutral. N is neutral. Neutral point. Okay. So generally, if I want to represent the star connection, I represent in the form of either Y connection or inverted Y connection. So let this be A. This is A dash. B, B dash, C and C dash connected to a common point, neutral. So this is RC, RA and RB. Okay. So this is how I get the star connection. Now what if I want for delta connection? Now for suppose I have the same three resistors, okay. I have the same three resistors here, RA, RB and RC. Now if I want to get the delta connection, what should I do? To obtain delta connection, how should I proceed? To get the delta connection, the second end of first element has to be connected to the first end of second element and it has to be continued. Okay. You can to understand, we can write is second end of first element is connected to first end of second element. Okay, then it is continued, and the second end of second element is connected to first end of third element. Second end of third element is connected to first end of first element. So if that connection is continued, okay, so I have these three resistors. Now I have to connect second end of first element to first end of second element. So this first end of second element is connected to second end of first element. Second end of second element is connected to first end of third element. And second end of third element is connected to the first end of first element. So this connection will give us the delta connections. And generally we write delta connection as like this. Now let this be terminal A, terminal B, and terminal C. So let this be terminal A, terminal A dash, terminal B, terminal B dash, terminal C and terminal C dash. So A dash is connected to B, A dash is connected to B, I will take it as B, B dash is connected to C, B dash is connected to C here, I will take this as C, then second terminal of C, C dash is connected to A, I will take this as A. So this gives RA, this gives RB, and this gives RC. So this is how I am getting a delta connection. Okay, this is very fundamental. Now, coming back to the complex circuit what we discussed here, you can observe that R1, R2 and R3, they are connected in a delta fashion. Is it?
Yes, sir.
R1, R2 and R3, they are connected in delta fashion. R7, R6 and R8, they are also connected in delta fashion.
Delta.
R1, R3, R4, they are in star. R3, R2 and R5, they are in star. Okay. R4, R7, R6 are in star. R6, R5 and R8 are in star. So it is a combination of delta and star connections. Is it? It is a combination of delta and star connection. So if I have a technique to resolve this delta star connection and simplify the things, then that technique is also one of the circuit reduction technique. But it has to be done equivalently. The star and the delta should always be equivalent. Okay? It is not random. Whatever the delta I will get from the star, this delta should be equivalent of star. Whatever the star I will get from the delta, the star should be equivalent of this delta. So it is very much important for me in the circuit reduction techniques, at each step of reduction or transformation, the next step should be, or the next circuit what we get in the next step should be the equivalent values circuit of the previous step. So that equivalence should not be missed at any point in the line of solution. If the equivalence is missed, then the solution is of different circuit than the original one. That has to be taken care. So whatever the thing we are discussing now, that is star delta transformation in this part, this is equivalent delta from star and equivalent star from delta. Okay, so that has to be taken care. So now we will look into the star delta transformation. In that, first we will see delta to star transformation. Delta to star transformation. Okay. So what does this mean is, I have a delta connected network. I have a delta connected network. And I want to get the equivalent star connection of that. So let the terminal be A, let this terminal be B, and let this terminal be C. So this is a delta connected network I have. So the resistance between A and B, I will call it as RAB for my convenience. Between A and B, RAB. Between B and C, this is C. Between B and C, let this be RBC. Between C and A, let this be RCA. So I have this equivalent sorry, I have this delta connected network, and I wish to have the equivalent star connected network. Okay. I wish to have a equivalent star connected network. The terminals are A, B, and C. Okay. So because this is the only resistance connected to terminal A, I will call it as RA. It has only resistance connected to B, I will call it as RB, and I will call it as RC. This is neutral. Neutral, we don't worry here. Yeah, but it is a neutral. So now RA should be equivalent, RB and RC should be equivalent values of this delta connected network. Okay. Whatever the star connected network I am getting from the delta, this star connected network should be the equivalent network of this delta connected network. And if I want to convert from star to delta, then delta connected network should be the equivalent of star connected network. That care has to be taken. Okay. Now we understood that whenever I want to convert from one connected circuit to other connected circuit, there should be an equivalence followed. But how to get that equivalence mathematically in the analysis? That is important. Okay, philosophically we saw that there should be equivalence followed. Okay, philosophically we saw there should be equivalence followed, because if the star connected network is not equivalent of delta connection, then this star connection is of no use for me, because it will give the totally different results. The values what I get will be of some other combination of circuit elements, not equivalent to this one. The circuit reduction techniques, why we are going for that is, I want simplification in the analysis without change in the output of the circuit. My grand output should remain same. It should not change. Okay. The circuit operation should remain same. So only I told in the first one or two class that whatever the exercise we are doing in this course, everything is on paper. It is everything only on paper. Physically, I am not doing anything. It is everything only on paper. So the equivalence should be followed. Now, how to follow the equivalence? Mathematically, I should be putting that. Okay. So basic principle is, basic principle of delta to star transformation is, the equivalent resistance between any two terminals should be same should remain same when transformed from delta to star. Because we are dealing with delta to star, we will take delta to star. So the equivalent resistance between any two terminals should be same when transferred from delta to star. Now the equivalent resistance between A and B, whatever I get in delta, between A and B in star, those should be equal. The equivalent resistance between B and C in delta should be equal to the equivalent resistance between B and C of star. The equivalent resistance between C and A of delta should be equal to the equivalent resistance between C and A of star. Now we got the method. Okay. Philosophically, first we see that equivalent resistance should be same. Methodically, we saw that between two terminals, if I keep the equivalent resistance same, then the transformation is valid. Now we have to see technically how we have to do it. Okay, how to get the equivalent resistance between two terminals? The equivalent resistance between any two terminals is obtained by opening the third terminal, by keeping the third terminal open circuit. Okay, you can take a note here. The equivalent circuit or the equivalent resistance between any two terminals is obtained or is obtained by taking equivalent resistance between two terminals by keeping third terminal open circuit. By keeping third terminal on open circuit or on open circuit. Okay. Now, if I have to find the equivalent resistance between, in both the cases it is true. Okay. It is in both star and delta. Okay, not only in star or not only in delta. Now, if I want to find the equivalent resistance between A and B, I should be keeping the terminal C open and find the equivalent resistance between A and B in delta. I should be keeping the terminal C open in star and finding the equivalent resistance between A and B in star. And when I equate these two, equivalent resistance of star and delta, okay, mathematically, if I equate these two, then my transformation will become valid. Okay. Now, suppose I have a delta connection here. Delta connection already we have there. Okay. Now, equivalent resistance between A and B. Can be obtained by keeping terminal C open. We will see how it can be done. Now this is a delta connected. This is A, B, and I have a open circuit in C. Okay, this is RAB, this is RBC, and this is RCA. Okay. Equivalently, I should be doing the same thing in star connection also. This is terminal A, terminal B, and terminal C. So let this be RA, RB, and RC. Now what is R equivalent in delta? Observe, when terminal C is open, there is no current flowing in the terminal C. Open circuit means there is no current flowing in the terminal C. So here at point C, now there is no node formation between RBC and RCA. Now when I keep the terminal C open, my RBC and RCA will come in parallel. And this parallel will come in series, sorry. When I open terminal C, my RBC and RCA will come in series, and this series is in parallel with RAB. That is my effective or equivalent resistance. Now in star, RC is out of the equation now, out of the question, because there is an open circuit, no current flows through RC. It is simply RA and RB are in series. So equivalent resistance between A and B is obtained by keeping terminal C open. If I want to find equivalent resistance between B and C, I should be keeping terminal A open. Okay. In that case, my RAB and RCA will be in series, that will be in parallel with RBC. If I want the equivalent resistance between A and C, I should be keeping terminal B open. In that case, RAB and RBC will be in series, that will be in parallel with RCA. Accordingly, on the other side, between A and B, it is RA plus RB. Between B and C, it is RB plus RC, RA will be open. Between C and A, it is RA plus RC, RB will be open. This is how we are finding the equivalent resistance in delta and star. So R equivalent delta is equals to, okay, R equivalent delta is equals to, or we'll give one more name here. R equivalent between A and B in delta is equals to, it is for our understanding. Now C is open, my RAB and RCA are in series. So it is, sorry, RBC and RCA. RAB is in parallel with RBC plus RCA, which is equals to RAB into RBC plus RCA divided by RAB plus RBC plus RCA. Or I can write this as RAB RBC plus RAB RCA. Divided by RAB plus RBC plus RCA. Okay. This is what we got. When I keep terminal C open and take the equivalent resistance between A and B. Now what about in star connection? are equivalent between A and B in star equals to. Okay, terminal C is open. It is simply R and RB are in series. It is simply R and RB are in series. Okay. So what is the principle of transformation? The principle of transformation is that the equivalent resistance between any two terminals should be same in star when transformed form delta. Okay. So for transformation, R equivalent star should be equals to R equivalent delta between any two terminals. So I can write it here from this as R equivalent between A and B in star is should be equals to R equivalent between A and B in delta. So this implies that R equivalent in A and B in star is RA plus RB. Okay. RA plus RB is equals to this term. RAB into RBC plus RAB into RCA divided by RAB plus RBC plus RC. You take this as equation one. Now similarly, I can take the equivalent resistance between B and C and between C and A. Okay. Similarly, I can take equivalent resistance between B and C and C and A, because between all the two terminals in star, it should be equivalent of that in delta. Okay. Next is, similarly, I can draw R equivalent between B and C, R equivalent between BC is keeping the terminal A open. This is RAB, RBC, RCA. This is equivalent to this is RA, RB and RC. So I can write here that RA plus RB plus RC is equals to, now RAB and RC are in series in parallel with RBC. So RBC in parallel to RAB plus RCA. This I can write it as RAB RBC plus RBC RCA divided by RAB plus RBC, direct I will write plus RCA. It is RBC plus RAB plus RCA. I will write in the arranged form only. Okay. What about between R equivalent between C and A? So when in C and A, terminal B should be open. So A, B, C, this is RAB, RBC, RC, which is equivalent to RC, RB, RC, sorry, this is RA, this is terminal A. So here it will be, now when B is open, RA plus RC, RA plus RC is equals to equivalent between A and C is by keeping B open. Now RAB and RBC are in series in parallel to RCA. RCA in parallel to RAB plus RBC. So this I will write it as RAB into one step I am skipping here. I hope is it okay? RBC into RAB plus RCA divided by RAB plus RBC plus RCA. Similarly, here you take this as equation 2, RBC plus RB plus RC is equals to. Similarly, this is RCA into bracket RAB plus RBC divided by RAB plus RBC plus RCA. Okay. RA plus RC. Take this as equation 3. Okay. So now we have got into the technical thing of making the two resistances equivalent between two terminals. Further part we will take it in the next class, because it is a bit lengthy, so I cannot finish it now. It is almost of the time of next class of yours, so we'll stop it here for today's session. And for next, in the next class or next tomorrow, I think it is holiday, there will be no class. If possible, I will record the class of this continuation or numericals of previous section, and I will forward it to you. Okay, but tomorrow there will be no class at 8:30. Okay. So.